Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Monica. For those who don't know me, you can follow my Instagram at Beauty by Berry. I am a licensed cosmetologist. I do also do hair and makeup. So if you guys need anybody to do your hair, I know mine doesn't look so good right now, but I'm letting it grow out. So if you need anybody to do your hair, do your makeup, so any special events, make sure you follow my Instagram. You can DM me total details and I will get back to you as soon as possible. I'll go ahead and teach you guys how to, this highlight, how to recreate this look. It's kind of like a pinkish tone with a little pop of glitter because you cannot stay away from glitter. So this is what I actually came up with using the Flamingo palette. I actually got this for $45 at BeautyCon, and it was like the best investment I ever made because it's really, really good. It's actually really pigmented and I love every single color in it. Not many colorful palettes have a black shadow like this palette does, but if you want to learn why this is in there, I actually used it creating this look. So if you want to see how I used it, make sure you stay tuned and watch this whole video. Alright guys, we're gonna start with the face. So for moisturizing, I like to use something with SPF. Of course, if you're gonna be outside, you need to have SPF so you can protect your skin. I use the Cetaphil, I actually get it at Target. Cetaphil with SPF 15 right there. So we're gonna go ahead and apply this all over the face. And the Cetaphil brand is actually for all skin types. So then to prime the face, I am gonna go in with the Benefit Professional to mix it with a Liquid Glow. And today I'm gonna be using the Liquid Glow and Peach Fizz by Anastasia. I usually mix them, but today I'm just gonna go ahead and apply the Liquid Glow right on the cheekbones. And then the Professional, I have a lot of open pores right here in this area, so I'm gonna go ahead and apply it there to fill them in on my nose. In this area right here and on the T-zone area. So now that my skin is ready to go, I'm gonna start with eyebrows today. These are my natural eyebrows as of now. I've been trying to grow them out, but not working. For my eyebrows, these are my must-haves. It's the Anastasia brow brush in 12. You can see it. Look how thin that is. And then the concealer brush in 18. It's a flat concealer brush, so it actually gets really good. Like, I like this area right here, how it's curved. Get right under the arch. Obviously, you know, you don't want to have too dark of an eyebrow. You want to make it look as natural as possible. For me, I prefer to use the Anastasia brow powder. As you can see, it's like super old. I use the color Granite. You can barely see it right there, but Granite. And I've had it for about, I don't know, since eyebrows were in. This was like the first major product that I actually bought, and it's still intact basically. I don't know why it turned like that, but I think from all the dipping. This color right here. And you want to take your time on your eyebrows because they are very, very important to your whole face. But I do. I'm telling that song to come back. Before I go in and clean the bottom of my eyebrow, I'm gonna prime my eyelids with Autofocus. Put it all over the lid. Make sure you're distributing the product evenly throughout the whole eyelid. Because if not, when you set it, it's going to be heavier on one side than the other. So now that we have primed and set the eyes, I'm going to go in with the Violet Voss Flamingo Palette. And I'm using the Morphe M534. It's my favorite blending brush. I'm going to go in with this color right here, Sand, as a transition color. Like you do, I'm feeling like the world's about to change. Hummingbirds are singing in the rain, dreaming that I'm standing in the light. Dreaming of me. Can you feel? I am gonna take this coral one and put it all over the eyelid. Not putting it on the eyelid, more so the crease area, and just bringing it a little bit higher than the crease area. Not all the way up here, but. Feels like this storm's holding back. Soon I'll be swimming in the dream. And same thing with eyeshadows, you wanna do a little bit at a time so that it's easier to blend as you go, opposed to putting in a bunch of product at a time, and it's gonna take you way longer to buff it out and to blend it out. Dreaming of that rainy summer day. Do you love me? Can you feel? Kind of just buff it out towards the brow bone area, not all the way right under it, just to give it, you know, that blend and circular motions. So now I'm taking my Morphe 506 brush, fun little blending brush, and I'm taking the color Watermelon. And I'm gonna apply it right in the crease area. I'm not blending it yet, I'm just applying it, dabbing it onto there, just to deepen the crease, but I still wanna stay in the pinks. So I'm just basically just dabbing it in. Kinda just deepened it a little bit. Kinda just bring it up a little bit higher so that it blends all in. The good thing about this little brush is it's a very, very small blending brush. So even if you're just dabbing it, it's kind of still blending the product itself. So I'm taking this Morphe pointer brush. It doesn't have a number, but I'm gonna add a little bit of more Watermelon into the same crease area just to make it a little bit darker. See, there's more product on it. And I'm also just dabbing it inside. Right in the crease area. I'm not blending anything out yet. So now I'm taking this other blending brush from the Morphe Rose Gold Collection. And so with this brush, I'm just gonna go ahead and blend it all in. I'm focusing only on the crease area. Make it brighter for me. So I'm doing circular motions on the outside and windshield wipers on the inside. I still want to darken up the crease a little bit more. I'm going to apply a dab of this, one dab of this, two dabs of this. Oh yeah, much better. So I'm going to go in with the Morphe E28 brush. It's actually more pointier. So I'm just gonna blend it inwards. Just make the whole look come together. This is a very simple look as long as you're blending properly. These are also very light shades, so they're easy to blend. So now I'm gonna go back with the Morphe 534. And I'm gonna take Flamingos over here. And I'm gonna go on the outside. Always circular motions. bring it up a little bit towards the brow bone. You want to dab it first and then go in and blend it. So now I'm taking the gel liner brush from the Rose Gold Collection, and I'm taking concealer and I'm going to cut the crease. I always start in the inner corner of the eye and start very, very small. Little by little, you want to take it higher and higher. When you're cutting the crease, you don't want to be really heavy with the concealer because then it's going to be very thick and it's going to be harder to set. So now that I've cut the crease, I want to blend it in. So I'm going to take watermelon again one more time. I'm going on the outer corner of the eye and I'm going upwards. And I'm just blending that in. I'm gonna deepen up the outer corners of the eyes with Sunnies and watermelon. So I'm gonna one dab here, two dabs here. See, it's like really, really dark right there. So the black, I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit of more pink and kind of just buff it out. Now I'm gonna take whatever product of the black is left and I'm gonna drag it upwards towards the crease area. Now I'm gonna take the E28 brush and applying more watermelon. Going back in with the concealer, I'm just gonna go ahead and clean it up a little bit. I do want a blank canvas on my eyelid for the color that I'm gonna apply here. And with no product on the brush, I'm taking the Morphe pointer brush and I'm just basically erasing the line that I created with the concealer. And remember, I didn't apply any product on this. I'm using it kind of like as an eraser. Of course, you want to go ahead and blend in everything. Taking my Morphe M534, and I'm just blending everything to make it very seamless. I'm taking the Anastasia blending eyeshadow brush in 30. And I'm taking Coral. I'm gonna apply it onto the lid, not too much, very lightly, and kind of like brushing it outwards, blending it into the crease area. I don't want too much of this color, I just want it very, very light. So now that I'm done with the eyes, as far as the eyeshadow goes, let me show you guys. Let's see. I'm gonna add a pop of glitter. There's something about it that needs some color in it. Need something to pop. So I'm gonna be taking the NYX liquid glitter. I really like this one because it has a really, really fine brush, kind of like the white eyeliner in my last video, but this one's actually finer. So you guys already know where it's gonna be applied. If you don't, keep watching, you'll find out. So I'm applying it right where the concealer, where I cut it, and the eyeshadow meet. Feels like this storm's holding back. Soon I'll be swimming in the dream. I walk, but I fall off the track to the blue. You got a little So since it was still a little wet, I kind of just scraped it off. Scrape it off. This brush, I actually use it for the bottom. Secrets, how I cover my dark circles and how I make it look so seamless. Right here I have a lot of little wrinkles under my eyes, so I just go ahead and apply a little bit of the professional right under the eye and I dab it in there. It kind of gives me like a smooth surface before I apply the corrector, so it's basically like blending out the little wrinkles that I have under my eyes. So I'm going in with the LA Girl Pro Concealer. Now I'm taking my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in the color 10. I'm applying it all over the bottom area. With the same brush, except on the opposite side that I used the corrector on. So I'm just gonna take my Real Techniques sponge. I'm gonna go ahead and dab it in there. So now moving on to my face, I'm going to use the Super Stay by Maybelline. And I'm going to apply more. And I'm just dabbing it right now so I can get the product around all over my face. On this area, on the top area, since I already cleaned up my eyebrows with my foundation, I just go ahead and dab a little bit. Most of the product that I poured onto my brush is on here. Make sure you want to get under your neckline. So now I'm taking my Real Techniques blending brush and I'm basically just dabbing my whole face. So to my hairline also, you want to make sure it's not under your hair, but blended inwards. Doesn't mean that you have to apply product on your hairline. Just kind of with the same beauty blender, just go in there. Now to highlight the under eye area, I'm using the Age Rewind by Maybelline. Kind of just take some product out. Make sure you're looking upwards when you do this. That way you can avoid any of the product just sitting on top of the little wrinkles that you have under your eyes. When you look up, it's kind of going in between. So right now I look a little crazy because I don't have any bronzer, nor blush, no highlight. So we're gonna take the Morphe 8L palette. And I'm taking the color Donut over here with the Morphe bronzer brush. So without lifting the brush, you wanna go ahead and basically bronze your face. The less you lift it, the less patchier it'll be. You see right there? Fall off the trail to the blue, to the blue. But I don't wanna look the other way. And I don't wanna wake up in a pain. Now I'm taking the Morphe 8W palette. And with the Rose Gold Collection, the blush brush. I'm taking MUA. This one. And a little bit of Unapologetic, so I'm just dabbing it onto there, and then kind of blending it inwards with the bronzer, not too much. Now I'm gonna carve my cheekbones. I don't contour This is probably the closest thing to contouring that I do, because I have really big cheeks again. So I'm dipping it into my Airspun setting powder and I'm carving up my cheeks from the middle of my ear downwards to the side of my lip. This is basically giving me the illusion that I have very, very defined cheekbones, even though I don't. Everybody knows that. I don't bake under my eyes because then it gets very heavy under my eyes. I'm basically melting the product in into my under eyes. This area right here, I do bake because I want to have it extra defined. So, and I'm also melting the product onto my face. Yes, my beauty blender is wet. Now that I have let it bake a little bit, I'm gonna go in with the BH Cosmetics 133 face brush and I'm gonna buff the whole thing out. And I'm going straight, I'm not doing any circular motions. And with the BH Cosmetics 128 brush, now I'm gonna go back in, dip into the color Debutante. It's a darker shade of this one. So I'm only dipping it in a little bit. And I'm gonna do circular motions right where I cut it. Alright, so now moving on to my under eyes, waterline. I'm taking this Morphe flat blending brush. Let me focus. Now I'm gonna take Coral. Put it right under my waterline. Now I'm gonna take the LA Girl brown eyeliner. I'm gonna apply it on my waterline. Darker on the outer corner and then kind of just fade it into the inside a little bit. Your favorite fade in the gray. Blue skies don't tease me like that. Now I'm gonna curl my lashes. So while the glue gets tacky on the lashes, I basically apply mascara on my one eye at a time so that I give the glue some time to get a little bit tacky. That way it sticks on really easily. I don't struggle. Multitask. Hope that's a girl. How easy that was. So I stick it right into the middle first and then I stick the corners of it. These are the double up lashes by Ardell. I got these at Sally's again. So I'm gonna take Seashell, dip it in and apply it right in the corner. Now it's time for my favorite part, of course. Highlight. I'm gonna spray my face before I do. So I'm taking the Sugar Glow Kit from Anastasia. I'm taking Butterscotch with the M510 brush by Morphe. My finger, I'm gonna take the same color. I'm gonna highlight the bridge of the nose. Just a little bit. And the tip of the nose. Sunshine. Make it brighter. Make it brighter. Back with the pointy brush, taking the same highlight and I'm highlighting my brow bone area. Said, can you feel sunshine? So to finish off and complete the whole look, I'm gonna apply Lazy Daisy by Dose of Colors.
game. So I'm gonna take watermelon again, one more time. Just kidding, that's flamingo.